What this new 12-speed C-Line and this 50-year-old Brompton Mark I have in common is the 3-speed internal gear hub. In fact, this type of hub has existed for over 100 years. In this video, we'll discuss what you need to know about the Brompton hubs, including their history, how to better use them, and what not to do. If you were to open a 3-speed Brompton hub, you would find a single-stage planetary gear system, consisting of a sun gear in the middle, surrounded by 4 identical planet gears attached together by a planet cage. A ring gear with inward-facing teeth meshes with the planet gears. The hub gear ratio is a function of the number of teeth of the ring and sun gears. With a 20-teeth sun and 60-teeth ring gear, the 3-speed Brompton has a 3/4 or 0.75 reduction in first gear. The friction between the various gears, bearings, and chain links creates a power loss of about 7% for a 93% power transfer efficiency. In third gear, the mechanical input and output inside the hub are reversed, so the 3/4 reduction becomes a 4/3 or 1.33 overdrive. As the planets turn faster in third gear than in first, the additional friction increases the power loss to about 8% or 92% efficiency. In second gear, the planetary gears are bypassed altogether, connecting the bicycle sprocket directly to the wheel, called direct drive. The power transfer loss is less than 5%, mainly due to bearings and chain. It's the reason why you should be using your second gear hub as much as possible while riding, as it's by far your most efficient gear. Brompton selected the Sturmey Archer 3-speed hub with its 177% range for the first 20 years of production. In the 90s, as the market demanded a wider gear range, the 5-speed version was introduced. Basically, a 3-speed hub with 2 ranges, high and low. The first model, the Star, required 2 shifters, one to select the sun-planet gear configuration, thus narrowing or widening the overall range, and a second one to select low, neutral, or high. An improved model, the Sprinter, released a few years later, simplified the shifter mechanism with a single lever from 1 to 5, while keeping the same 225% range. In 2000, after 100 years in business, Sturmey Archer went bankrupt, forcing Brompton to quickly change suppliers. They selected the SAC-SRAM 3-speed with its 186% range and slightly better power efficiency. The first Bromptons we purchased, 2 2001 T3s, are equipped with the SRAM hub. They can easily be recognized by their torpedo shifter. They're still working flawlessly 25 years later. As SRAM didn't have a Brompton-compatible 5-speed hub replacement, they introduced a 20-year-old solution, initially made by a company named Cyclo, which attached 2 sprockets and a derailleur to the 3-speed hub for a total of 6 speeds and 214% range. This also signaled the return of the dual-shift lever arrangement that remains to this day. Meanwhile, Sturmey Archer was purchased by Sunrace and relocated to Taiwan. By 2005, they were once again able to supply Brompton. By 2009, they released 2 hubs specifically for the Brompton, the BSR, or Brompton Standard Range, a rebranded regular 3-speed hub, and the new wide-range hub, the BWR, which was designed in cooperation with Brompton. To achieve a wider ratio, the size of the 4 planet gears was reduced from 20 to 12 teeth. This decision came with a few compromises, however. Smaller gears are more fragile and result in more power loss. The resulting range is 246%, somewhat similar to the 5-speed range. The larger gap between each gear was designed to accommodate a dual sprocket arrangement, thus providing a total range of 302%. The 6-speed configuration would remain for another 15 years until Brompton repackaged the BWR to accommodate their 4-sprocket cassette. This new hub, called Ultralight, has been the basis of the new 12-speed Bromptons. The total range is 402%, but it does generate some gear overlap, effectively reducing the number of gear ratios to 10. Finally, in 2025, Brompton introduced a new hub to equip the G-Line 20-inch wheel bike, the Alpine 8-speed from Shimano. As with all internal gear hubs, the most efficient gears, identified here in green, are the ones that provide direct drive, or a gear ratio of 1. When more than one sprocket is used, the bigger one is the most efficient. Similarly, in a 3-gear setup, the third gear on the smallest sprocket is the least efficient. In contrast, the efficiency analysis of the Alpine Hub shows its fourth gear is the least efficient. Two factors can affect hub life expectancy: improper gear adjustment and excessive input torque. Brilliant Bikes has a good video on gear adjustments, so you can find out more at the link provided below. Information about maximum input torque is tough to find. The value of 50 Newton meters is often quoted. High torque can be created during sudden acceleration or hill climbing. Assuming a 16T sprocket, 50T chainring, and 170 millimeter crank, we can easily compute the force at the crank, about 920 newtons, or the equivalent of a 94 kilogram or 200 pound rider putting their entire weight on the crank. The maximum force or weight on the pedals changes depending on the Brompton gear setup. Using the 33T chainring, for example, we'd reduce this limit to 610 newtons or 62 kilograms. Should we worry about breaking the hub? Let's set ourselves a limit of 600 newtons and take a closer look at the forces at play under normal conditions. The force applied by the rider varies depending on the angle of the crank. Maximum force is applied when the pedal is between the 3 and 4 o'clock positions. Assuming a casual rider generating 100 watts, the maximum force applied will be about 130 newtons, considerably less than our self-imposed 600 newton limit. For reference, 100 watts represents riding your Brompton at about 22 kilometers per hour on flat terrain. As we increase the rider power output to climb hills, for example, the force applied to the crank will increase as well. At 400 watts, it reaches 450 newtons, still significantly less than our 600 newton limit. Eventually, the peak force measured will depend on the cadence and fitness of the rider, but an untrained rider will reasonably be able to maintain 400 watts for only 1 minute. So, in normal cycling conditions, the hub won't break, but sudden high torque may cause damage. It's wise to refrain from high torque, particularly during hill climbing with a loaded bike. Similarly, hub gear changes should be done under low torque conditions. To sum up, the hub's low maintenance, robustness, and reliability make them an ideal choice for utility bikes like the Brompton. Proper gear adjustment is essential for the optimum longevity. Refer to Brilliant Bike's YouTube video for details. Riders should mainly use the direct drive gear, the second gear for the Brompton hubs, and the fifth for the Alpine 8-speed. High torque conditions, like putting your full weight on the crank, should be avoided, especially if you have a smaller chainring. As a rule of thumb, Sturmey Archer suggests a drive ratio between chainring and sprocket that is greater than 2 to 1. Using the 33T chainring with a 16T sprocket is within this limit. Configuring the 3-speed hub in a dual-drive 6-speed configuration was a clever solution to the shortage of 5-speed hubs, but that was 25 years ago. The short-term fix became a long-term solution and paved the way for the 12-speed dual-drive. Meanwhile, the Brompton G-Line broke the tradition and introduced the Shimano Alpine 8-speed. We wonder if this is not the route the new C-Line should have taken as well. As it stands, it seems the 3-speed hub is here to stay for another 20 years. What do you think about the slow evolution of Brompton's 3-speed hub? Let us know in the comments below. We're Pam and Gilbert of Two Bikes for Adventure.